Hey everyone, Pilot Steve here. How's it going? Just another day, another solid. Just doing a little short transition to executive airspace. I just came back out from Rio Linda, and I went to Hayward to drop off Holly, and now I'm just flying back. And I said, you know what? I'm gonna throw on the camera and tell you guys a quick little story before I go in and do the approach into executive, into Rio Linda. So, I think today I'm going to tell you guys a good story of how my parents deceived me and told me they gave me a $3,000 watch. It was worth $50, not even, you know, that's how much they paid for it. And to this day, they claim that it was worth $3,000, and they didn't know, and all this and that. But this story begins on my 20th birthday. So they got me a, what I thought was a limited edition Invictus worn by someone special with a signature edition, right? And come to find out, Invicta watches aren't really worth much at all. You know, they're kind of the thing that people wear in the Bronx to make themselves look a little fancy. They're nothing too special. So I'm going around flexing this thing everywhere I go, showing everyone, like, oh yeah, look at my cool watch, you know? And, no, I got flabbergasted when I was actually flying with my buddy Jake, you met in another video, and he looks up the serial number on the back, and he goes, bro, this thing's worth, like, $50, and he shows me, oh, a Walmart, they have it for sale for, like, dirt cheap, and I'm kind of pissed. I'm like, what? No, this isn't right. And he goes, yeah, man, and we looked it up, and then we find all this info. I'm like, this can't be right. So we decide to take it to a watch collector, I guess you could call it. They're, you know, they're people who vend in jewelry. And we take it there, and once we get to Humboldt, when I was flying with my buddy Jake, and he goes, yeah, man, this thing ain't worth nothing. So I'm visibly upset. And we go, well, my parents got it for me, still it's a sentimental value. But you know what? I'm gonna go ahead and have some fun with this watch, if you catch my drift. So legally, this is another part, the FAA says that you can drop things out of an airplane if it's over your own property. So Jake just so happens to have a bit of property up in Humboldt, so we decide to put this watch to the test. We decide, you know what, he has a large piece of property, we're gonna throw this watch out the window and find it on the property, and if it still works, I'll keep it. So, you know what, we decide to do, we go up and down, go up to 4,000 feet over his property in the beautiful Humboldt County of California, and we dropped that watch right out the window. And as it fell, it hit the trees and, you know, went all the way down and hit the ground. We, to this day, still cannot find it. But when I do, next time I'm on his property, I'm going to check if that thing works still. And if it works, I'll keep that watch. But that's a little story time with Steve while I'm flying in good old Juliet here. I'll talk to you guys soon. Hope you're having a good day.